You would have thought, okay, so after the success of the Euros, could they be able to sustain this yep. level of play? Could they be able to sustain a World Cup qualifying campaign? And, man, were they able to do so. It really gives a lesson on how to maximize the assets that you have available to you. We talk about the size of talent pool in many different countries. Well, the size of the talent pool in Iceland is as small as anybody else's, and yet they're able to identify, nurture, and develop that talent in a way in which these guys now come to the full national team and are able to deliver in a moment in which you would have thought, maybe this moment is too big for Iceland.
Yep.
And it wasn't.
No.
It wasn't. This player is able to deliver a performance. They get the points that they need, and they're going to the World Cup, well-deserved by Iceland.
Yeah, definitely. We've got a movement going between them and their fans. We've got that, I don't know, what do you call that? I don't know, that chant.
Do yeah. it on, do it, let me see.
No, can't do it.
Thunderclap, it's a thunderclap.
Thunderclap, that's the one. The players are not the most talented around Europe. Mm-hmm. They have got some talent in the team, but they're big and strong. They're organised. And sometimes that can take you a fair distance. It did at the Euros. And to win the group, not just clamber in via some playoff that they might have been thrown into, which have been coming up in the next couple of weeks, but to actually win that group is amazing, and they deserve to be.